Hello and good morning and welcome to Walking in Victory with Viv. So today I'm talking a little bit about cleaning the lights. So what does that mean to clean the lights? So about 30 years ago, I started a cleaning service when my daughter Shentelle was 5 years old. And I started it so I could take her to school, pick her up and spend time with her, you know. Because each mother wants to do it, especially, you know, when your child is young. So I made good money doing it, but I gave it up about 5 years ago. Now my real calling is being in real estate. It's my passion to see no one homeless in Central Florida. Always clean the light. What does that mean? Clean the light is essential. Without a good clean light and sanitized home, you may get sick. Always clean the light. It will let you see better. With all that is going on in and around the world, only a few things are essential, as we can see. And cleaning the light is one of them. Thank you to all those cleaners out there. To a job well done. Your job is essential, and you have to know that. That's why we clean the hospital. That's why we clean home, restaurants, streets, and everything. So our job is essential when we're a cleaner. So always clean the light. Cleaning your home and making it your castle. There is no place like home. When the light is too far up in the ceiling, you don't normally get a chance to clean the light. But once the light are clean, wow, what a difference does it make. When you clean the light, the darkness disappear and everything will shine because the light shines through darkness. Isn't that awesome? There is light in each and every one of us that needs to be taken care of, that must be nurtured, loved, danced to the music. We need to make our light shine through for others to see. Don't hide your lights. You never know who needs to see it. So how to clean a light and a light fixture and the light bulbs? Maintaining your light fixtures can be a chore. Yes, it can. But dirty chandeliers or pendulums are not a good look. Unclean light bulbs reduces brightness, which is a waste of energy. The U.S. Department of Energy says dirty light bulbs provide 30% less light than the clean ones. So clean it regular. It is a great habit to get into. First and foremost, always make sure the power to the bulb is turned off. Removing any plug connected to the bulb is essential and recommended. Or for extra precaution, turn off the light at the circuit breaker if you can. Even after the power is turned off, it is essential to wait until the bulb cools. I've done that plenty of time where I don't wait till it cools and all of a sudden pop, it pops. So wait until it cools before you start cleaning it. Take a dry cloth. And once it's cool, you wipe it down to get rid of all the grimes, the dust, and everything like that that's on it. If possible, once or twice a year, take down your chandeliers and wash those crystals so they will shine their brightest. Matthew 5:16 says, "In the same way, let your light shine before others that they may see your good deeds and glorify your Father in heaven." Psalms 27:1 says, "The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? No one except for the Lord." John 12:35-37 says, "Then Jesus told them, 'You are going to have the light just a while longer. Walk while you have the light, before darkness overtakes you. Whosoever walk in the dark does not know where they are going. Believe in the light while you have the light, so that you may become children of the light.' When he has finished speaking, Jesus left and hid in himself from them." Let's pray. God, with you there is no darkness. Your character has no shadows. And you are pure and good. Yet our hearts are broken we have a broken world. We see so much darkness around us, Lord. Pain, sickness, and virus and disease are in our community and in many of our homes. Bring your light and restore presence to the dark place in our lives. Bring your hope to hearts that feel defeated. Bring your love and compassion to those that are in pain. Give us faith to say with the psalmist, Lord, you light my lamp. My good illuminates my darkness. May your light of hope shines in the darkness for families today. Show us a glimpse of your presence with us and the comfort you bring. In the busyness of today, help us to take a moment to be still and sit with you, to slow down, breathe deeply, and release our burdens to your strong arms. You are trustworthy, God, and true, and we thank you for caring for us so deeply and beautiful. Open our eyes to see you at work today. Give us your light, Lord, and may you always live inside of us. In Jesus' name, amen. Remember, if you need to be prayed for, leave me a message, like, comment, and share. And I look forward to seeing you next time in Walking in Victory with Viv. Take care.